Welcome to episode 13, unlucky for some. We're on the Carl Rae Pass, and we are undergoing quite a challenge here. We've just passed the Gritter lorry, which has been coming the other way. Hopefully we're going to be able to get across and not down one of the precipitous...
Stop, don't say that.
No, okay.
Just
sorry,
drive. Darling. Just keep your eyes on the road and drive.
Anyway, episode 13. This should be a bundle of laughs. Perhaps some secrets being revealed today.
We've been snowed out, which is a bit like snowed in, except we couldn't get home yesterday, so we camped out with our friends Maggie and Chris in Lower Breckish, and now we're going home, hopefully.
Yeah, hopefully.
And at that point, we hit the bit where the gritter kindly forgot to grit. Clearly, getting home was not going to happen that night. 2 days later, thanks to our wonderful neighbour Dave and his hefty 4x4, we got a lift over the Carl Rae Pass. This really is one of the most stunning areas of sky, never more so than when there's a foot of snow on the ground and clear blue skies. Today we felt like we'd been transported into an episode of Ice Road Truckers. If you want to experience it for yourself, book our jeep tour to Glenelg and Arnisdale. You get all these views, just without the snow, and a ride in the famous ferry. South Skye has so much to offer. Thank goodness it isn't on the TripAdvisor top 10, otherwise it would be swarming with tourists. In our opinion, this is where the magic is.
Is that big enough? Is it?
Snow is fun stuff, especially when you're a three-month-old puppy.
Kylie, do it.
Kylie, going to make snowball?
Yeah, no, we're making a snowman.
At that age, the vet says it's all about acclimatising your puppy to the world around them. So here we are showing her that some human adults can have the mental age of about 6.
What are you, bit? I see. Oh, look at that, sweetheart. Yeah, look.
It's taken Lynn over 25 years to get me to agree to getting a puppy, and gradually she's worn me down. I'm ever so glad she did, though. We love Kylie to bits.
Yes, we're going to make them. Don't ruin it. Look. Come on, then.
From the very outset, we set up some strict rules. No dogs on the furniture. No tasty morsels of human food from the dinner table. And no dogs are ever allowed on the bed. Needless to say, the training is not going all that well. It seems she is training us and not the other way round. She has us wrapped round her little paws.
That's good. Right.
Kylie, next one. Kylie!
Okay.
Kylie.
As you might have already noticed, it's winter. Time to do some bottling.
It's orange time in Spain. So little orange marmalade is what we're making here. And I've got a little cut on my finger and it stings to buggery, but there we go, can't be helped. Kylie is helping by leaving little puddles on the floor. Thank you, Kylie. It's all a bit of a major biohazard, this whole affair, but never mind.
You taking the piss?
Marmalade is, as any self-respecting Scotsman will tell you, a Scottish invention. Legend has it that a ship carrying oranges was wrecked off the Dundee coast, and the locals wasted no time in gathering them in, thinking how lucky they were to have this free, exotic foodstuff land on their shores. They were less than overjoyed when, upon eating the fruit, they discovered them to be inedibly bitter, hence the term bitterly disappointed. The Scots are a resourceful lot, and rather than let the fruit go to waste, they bottled it up with loads of sugar, and marmalade was invented. And if you believe that, you'll also believe in Scottish fairies and the Loch Ness Monster. Marmalade actually dates back to the 16th century, possibly even earlier, and breakfast just wouldn't be the same without it. Fortunately, the snow melted in time for Lynn and I to take a trip to Somerset to play some music. We're both musicians, don't you know? And the delights of Britain's Peter Grimes and the hit show Hairspray were to be our employ for the next couple of weeks.
Want to come and sit in?
Well, you get in that side.
Quite precise.
You get in that side, sweetheart.
All right.
Lemmy had gone to his new owner, Terry, in the Black Isle, and we were in a position to get a 4x4 of our very own. Of course, it had to be a Jeep.
I love the driving position.
Good, isn't it?
Gosh, it's brilliant.
The vision you get's excellent, isn't it?
It just changed. I felt something change. Ah, I didn't do anything.
You don't have to do a thing.
When I get excited, I might go a bit Geordie mind.
Hey, help okay? yourself.
So,
can someone translate for me, please?
So I don't
That's
have
what
to...
I see at work.
A quick test drive, some paperwork, and an eye-watering Visa card payment later, and Sky Jeep right, Tours take possession of Jeep number 2. The purchase of a 4x4 couldn't have been more timely. We had to get back to Skye, but the weather seemed keen for us not to get there.
I don't think we're going to get through Glencoe, sweetheart.
As we drove, the conditions got worse and worse and worse. It was getting late, and we weren't even at Fort William yet. While Lynn drove our new Pride and Joy, I sat in the passenger seat and read the instruction manual. The four-wheel drive system is a little more developed than Mary Ann's, but I think we'll get the hang of it, if we don't crash first.
Morning, viewers! I'm so pleased we bought a Jeep, because this is what the weather's done on our first journey.
Little do we know, but a huge articulated lorry is also hurtling towards the roundabout. We haven't seen him, and he certainly hasn't seen us.
Oh shit!
I was skidding.
Blimey, that was close. After an overnight stop in Fort William, we were back on the road. As you can see, the previous night's close encounter with a 40-ton Arctic didn't dampen the mood. As we were in a Jeep, we would be allowed to sing the Jeep song. Sorry about that. Perhaps some shots of our new wheels and some Scottishy type music would be more appropriate. Here we go.
Don't you wish your girlfriend was